racer on September 10th had a baby that was either stillborn or died right after birth, and she just held it on her head all day long. It was just so sad. And the researchers didn't even give that baby a number, which I highly disagree with. So maybe we could think of a name for her baby. It was a little girl. Well, eventually, there's Racer. Eventually, she would have just had to let it go, and it would sink to sink. At some point in time, with decomposition, you get the gases and intestinal gases, and then they sometimes will float for a little while. But initially, it's negative buoyancy. I think we're the same way. Anything is like that. Except, I guess, right whales were called right whales, the right whales to hunt, because they had maybe so much fat, I think it was, that they would float even when they were freshly dead. So they were called the right whales to hunt. Well, she looks like this. She has this very distinctive arcing black stripe.
Racer.
It was probably for the letting go breathing ritual. You don't do that with the youngsters, especially. And sometimes more other members of the tribe will do that. They'll hold the baby and pass it around. They very, very definitely grieve the loss of their family. Especially, you see it, there's an older female in the northern resident group that lost her adult son, and they'd been together for decades, and she was extremely mournful for a long time, and another female traveled with her who has three adult sons, and that made a difference. After a couple weeks of that, she was back with her other family members. I know, you're listening to the hydrophone.
Male right there.
Yeah, that big fin's a male. This one that's on the surface, I think, is listening to the hydrophone. Saying, oh. Yeah. You see that little one?
She's listening.
On the hydrophone. That's so cute. That's so cute. So these guys just didn't stop. Oh, they're aware of us, but they come up and swim by us. They might be able to hear up that high, but most every sound they make is within our ability to make sounds and hear sounds. That's what's one of the nice things about orcas. Whereas a lot of dolphins and porpoises are up above our normal hearing, and a lot of the big baleen whales are below our normal hearing. You are user-friendly whales. Oh, look at that beautiful line. One of the things these resident orca whales do that is a greeting ceremony. So they'll line up shoulder to shoulder in a straight line on the surface, one group coming and approaching another group that's approaching them. And they just swim right at the surface in this nice straight line until they meet one another. And then they break ranks and have parties.
Like crushing the gym during the dance or something.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
That's what I pictured.
Yeah, it is. It's a very formal ritual.
Dance boys and girls.
Well, no, it's like J-Pod.
Oh, I get you.
They roll around all over each other. not even the ones